comes to looking and feeling beautiful both inside and out, every one of us is working with a different box of tools. Some of us were born with certain tools that others don't have, which give us an advantage in certain ways, and we can use our one-of-a-kind collection of tools to create beauty that no one else can duplicate because they don't have our exact set of tools. On the flip side, all of us are missing at least a few tools we wish that we'd been given. And while it's possible to acquire many types of tools, some are inherent and cannot be changed. And this can cause us to sit and look at our toolboxes with all kinds of negative emotions about it. And these negative emotions usually come about because we either compare our toolbox to someone else's whom we deem more valuable in some way, or we have experienced or witnessed negative feedback about ours or similar types of toolboxes. I believe that this is true for pretty much everyone. However, the difference between the beauty that some people cultivate and use to help themselves become happier and more successful compared to some others lies in the way in which they view and use the valuable tools that they've been given. Perception is everything. It's actually reality. I've come to see that every single one of us has a wealth of beauty and happiness potential inside of our toolboxes. But the key to the kingdom is in the way that we view it. I hope that your brain is starting to make some correlations in this analogy, and you're looking at your own set of tools with fresh eyes. I imagine being in the garage looking at my husband's big red Sears tool cabinet, which used to be his dad's from back in the day. And I see all the screwdrivers, saw-like thingies, hammers, wrenches, nails, screws, etc. I see some rusted doodad thingies. I see some tools that I don't actually recognize. I see duplicates of the same types of tools, and also a lack of the just right tools that we've sometimes needed for certain projects. My husband can get sometimes frustrated or even angry when he's loaned something to someone to use and they've not returned it. And sometimes he can't even remember who took it from him. But there's a void there and a need for that tool. So what is opening up for you now when you think about your own toolbox? What do you see in there? How can you use your unique set of tools to go a step further and elevate your life? Really methodically take inventory of the tools you have. Take pen to paper and truly evaluate the tools you have at your disposal. What value can you find in those tools? Think of the tools as assets, skills, or characteristics. Take time and get innovative with looking at all the uses and ways to create beauty with what you have. You can take a look at what you still might need to acquire in order to maximize the tools you already have. And you can start to discover what you have that could help equip or improve someone else's toolbox to make a difference. I would encourage you to allow yourself time to journal about this. Take some time to sit and write. Let your thoughts flow and see where it takes you. I believe you will make discoveries in this exercise that will open up your eyes to possibilities you never considered before. I believe this type of exercise is deeply therapeutic and motivating. It has been for me. Practices like this will show you your unique worth and reinforce your beauty inside and out so that you can look at it and remember all the ways that you are breathtakingly beautiful and equipped in the world. Let the words flow out on paper and see what happens. You will teach yourself. You'll make discoveries you never stopped to make before. And I promise you, this type of practice will help you find direction, purpose, motivation, and inspiration. It is a great reset when you feel defeated and tired. It's a great way to find renewed energy. Just the act of listening to yourself in this way, blocking out the rest of the world's noise for a little while, can have a great impact. So comment here to let me know what comes up for you. I'd love to know what you discover.